Amazing Hazard as we see Nelvin and Clipboards going full.
Oh, we're starting.
Literally went full return to Monkey a second ago, just like banging on his chest as we start things off here in game number one. How are you feeling in terms of, like, we know what Numbers brings to the table, but how are you feeling about Nelvin's chances here in this matchup?
So the cool thing with Diddy is, like, if Numbers goes to the ledge and is playing his camp game, which he will at some point, Diddy can arm himself with Banana, which helps his ledge trapping so much. You got Z-drop down air. I mean, how active that down air is and how good it is. Diddy can arm himself. A lot of good, honestly, long-range Banana plays so far from Nelvin. Flying into the header, though, just a little bit, taking some damage here.
Yeah, this matchup is so funny because one of the things that we fatate is good ledge trappers, especially with, like you said, the Z-drop the Banana into free spikes. But Diddy really hates zoners. So Numbers is going to be playing a whole lot of Sun Salutation harassment as well as using the volley to constantly catch him when he tries to jump maybe with Funky Flips, because Nelvin is a very big fan of using side B.
There it is. Speaking of, you're going to be seeing that, yeah, for sure. Well, and Diddy, it's just such a good tool, and it seems like Nelvin's just playing at this good range to fight Numbers, for sure. Okay, here we go. Pressure at the ledge, this is what I'm talking about. The fake out with the Z. That hit the right side of shield? That's crazy.
I don't know how carried. That's all I got to say. Nelvin coming in. Oh, good shield discipline. You need to be careful whenever.
Up smash.
Oh,
nice.
Good job.
Good patience,
nice.
Yeah.
Like, that situation right there, like, if you swing wrong, you die anyways. So Sun Salutation is going to get the kill. We're back to an even game.
Up B, back to the ledge here. You already know what it is. John Numbers Show taking the banana. Wow, that was a good secondary toss, too. I'm surprised it didn't connect. Nelvin, though, this is the game we're going to see a lot here. Nair at the ledge, Z-drop banana. What is it going to be from Nelvin? Looking for forward air, too. Getting aggressive, but here comes Numbers off the side. Good dash attack to clear out some space. Clean.
I actually really like that dash attack from ledge, too, because it shows, like, a level of I'm not scared of you, and so I'm going to push you back to center stage. That's where Numbers has to win, because the entire time, if Nelvin wants to win this game, it's like you just said. Ooh. He has to win at the ledge.
Yeah. Oh, what? That was the highest up banana I've ever
honestly
seen.
I didn't even realize the banana was
what
out.
The heck? And there, right there, punish. Forward throw. Pressure at the ledge here. See what Numbers does off the side. Nice. Delayed roll. I mean, Numbers attacks a lot from the ledge, especially you see the header coming out. So the delayed roll is going to be a good mix-up to have, too.
Yeah, good spot that to get by, but immediately covered is Nelvin. Nelvin getting a percent right back into favor. Tries to look for a down tilt to maybe catch a fair. You know, I actually like that. With deep breathing on deck, normally you want to run away, but Sun Salutation with that much charge, you're going to die every time.
Nelvin again. A couple down tilt conversions, a couple fares, good damage, but that is not. Numbers doesn't really care, honestly. I mean, he does, obviously. You don't want to take damage, but until you lose the stocks, it doesn't really matter. Offstage, header to stall. Very nice. Nelvin, but that's what I'm saying, is you get to set up as Diddy. Go ahead, take your time getting back to the ledge. I'll arm myself, get the banana ready. But if Numbers takes it, seems like very proficient with the banana too.
If Numbers jump there, that header spikes and Nelvin's over. Like, speaking of high recoveries being controlled, you gotta watch out where you go.
Oh my god, I thought that was it. I thought Numbers had it.
So good at getting edge guards. Like, Numbers is not afraid to go off stage ever. That's where he lives. Right now, Nelvin, like, he can't afford to do so because he's at 102.
You're here again, tricking him into grabbing the banana at the time. The up smash, it's going to be so key in this matchup for Nelvin.
Yeah.
As it is in most city matchups.
Yeah,
real.
Like, it's so annoying because, like, most of the time you can use banana to kind of control neutral the entire time.
Woo! Schmoven! Oh my god, if that killed, I would have popped off, dude. That was sick. That was actually sick anyway.
I forgot how much shield, like, pushback F-Tilt has from Wii Fit. Like, actually just pushed Nelvin away the entire time. Like, oh, wait, side B coming in? Nelvin does have banana in hand. Granted, back throw is going to push him deep off stage. Force the jump. Is he going to be able to get by?
Nice.
Wow, what an aggressive up B.
Yeah, going right at him, too. Charging for such a long time, it looked like he was going to commit to go to the ledge. So just good mix-ups from Nelvin. The timing is good.
Oh.
Working so hard on this game one. Dropping it for Nelvin would be really bad. John Numbers trying to close it out here, though. Center state. All right, you know, I was, like, building the whole story. I was trying to, you know. Going places.
It wasn't even fully charged Sun Salutation either.
It's like
three quarters.
But honestly, it's a really. Who would expect that? Because you think he's going to fully charge it to hold it till later, or at least shoot it and heal up a little bit. But no, the mix up was really good.
Look, Haz, if it makes you feel any better, I would buy your audiobook about Wii Fit Trainer. I would listen to
it. I like Wii Fit, to be honest with you.
Wii Fit is one of those, like, Wackadoo is like the only description I can think of. Like, it's just one of the weird characters we never expected to get in this game, but has like such a unique factor with the 80 plus characters we have in this game. You must know the Wii Fit matchup in a major, otherwise you're going to get upset. And it is just so difficult to fight if you don't understand.
There's a couple of really good Wii Fits out there too. You got it. It's a very neat. What? 70? We're 5 seconds into the game, AJ. What the heck? The Numbers Show.
That's just Wii Fit sometimes. Like, they don't have a lot of, like, combos. They pretty much only look for falling there into whatever. But when they do hit, especially with Sun Salutation, they hurt so much. You better watch out for that high recovery. Numbers is going to control the options.
The wind box on that Sun Salutation, too. You set up off stage, try to mess with the Diddy's recovery in any way you can. Numbers with the lead, going to go off stage and get a little aggressive there. I'd like to see it.
Yeah, I mean, I do like the Z-drop pressure that Nelvin has had, but he keeps looking for a lot of nairs, and he keeps doing that same. Yeah, I had a feeling that was going to happen. He keeps doing the side B cancel off to the edge and then coming back in with back air. That's only going to trick Numbers like once or twice. Yeah. You can't keep doing that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Numbers obviously, you know, ready for set play, ready to really figure out your patterns as a player, and you can see he's already taken off with this lead here. Already up with stock AJ and trying to extend that lead even more.
Yeah, like the only thing that could kind of be rough for Diddy Kong sometimes is they can struggle to kill at high percents without a banana confirm. So with the ability of Numbers to heal and how good he is on defense, he'll camp you. You don't care. He's willing to play the clock. We've seen it time and time again against Sinji.
That, dude, and the chances of Numbers being caught on the ground with a banana, not super high. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? He's going to be in the air at the ledge a lot, like just mixing it up, trying to get Nelvin to overextend and take a stop here. I'm sure that's the plan.
Yeah, and this is like, this is just a testament to how you fight this matchup. Like, look, oh, the coverage. You can't jump high, and then you just...
That was the deepest of breathings, dude. That was like, so good.
Yo, see, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out.
Oh, my God. The juke, though? The 1-2? Numbers is sick, dude.
I mean, I'm surprised that that dash deck didn't get a follow-up or anything, but look at, like, you see Nelvin looking for the option cover, trying to catch the tech in place. Misses out, though. This is just a testament to how difficult Diddy, like, deals with zoning-based matchups. Because, like, he's not moving. He's just throwing headers and Sun Salutations at him.
Honestly, it's like the lobs are working so well for Nelvin. Like, just kind of going that mid-range banana off the ledge, okay? See there, it's like, is it going to be a hitbox? Is it going to be an air dodge? What's it going to be? Dash attack, though. Good pressure. Andy's in a good spot to pick up the banana. Throws it away, though. And clearing some space with the header. This is really good play from Numbers up the ledge again.
Yeah, there's that very aggressive dash attack you mentioned before. And then doing it again. Numbers recognizes, you know what? It's worth the trade if I go for it.
Wow. Banana. What an item grab, man. That was a start-stop.
I thought he was going to run
red
right
light,
into
it. Red light, green light. Me too. Me too. It was really good control, though. Dead.
Maybe not that. Amongst all the options you had, that one was lettered STOOPID. You're looking kind of stupid. Don't do that again.
Oh, God. Down air, though. Nelvin tried to respond here. 820, though.
Why did that work? He got the grab, then he got the banana to come back down, and then was able to get the forward smash. You know what? Big brain. Right now, he needs to get a simple banana into anything, but, like, the shield discipline. Going for these aggressive upbees again.
Mm-hmm. Getting in there, too. Falling for... Oh, slipping. Falling. Can't get up. He did, actually. Oh, yeah!
What? You know what? That's so scary, because if you air dodge, that's dead. Numbers is going to header you or down air you every time. Almost gets the roll reads as up smash takes his own. Can Nelvin get the damage back? We've seen what Diddy can do with, like, one good opening. Numbers has just kind of been making sure he doesn't get many.
Nice. I like the retreating banana, trying to catch the tech in, trying to get the roll or the neutral get up anyway. But Nair at the ledge can be the set or the game closer here for Nelvin too. Don't forget Nair to down air, super good.
I mean, he's at percents where banana down air, that is a very strong spike.
Yeah.
That could steal the game,
especially with the rage.
Numbers is such a troll. Where did that hit? Why did that hit behind like that? What is this character? I don't know, but literally T-posing on top of Diddy Kong.
See, umpire is safe, you know what I mean? But not safe. See you later. Get him out of here. And one. Here we go. Dunk. Boom.
You know what? That was one of those moments where you did too much tech skill for no reason. You saw that. You saw how Nelvin was in center stage. He was looking for like a pop gun cancel or something to try and get Numbers to move forward. It comes
Numbers
up in about
this.
A second.
He did this. He hit him with a shmoove, dude.
Going
left, going right. Oh, I'm going this way.
Right there. He did it just before that. He did the pop gun cancel. And what did that? What did that net you? That net you stage position for Numbers, who was able to blow you up for that dumb decision. I love watching Nelvin play. Big fan of him for a long time. Another CT homie, big player. Fighting against Numbers like that, it just doesn't work.
No, and it's just one of those things where you kind of get into a natural rhythm of playing the game. Like, you're kind of in danger, so you spot dodge. But exactly, Numbers is one of those players that's going to break you down like that, you know. He's got a chalkboard, you know, a big chalkboard. He's writing all the notes on it.
This is somebody who has had success with a very obscure character for a long time. Good job getting the reversal, yeah. Now, can he get something out of this has?
This is where Numbers capitalize, though. Like, yeah, you can get those sick hits. Yeah, you can hit him off stage every once in a while, but he lives at the ledge, man. Yep. That's where his house is.
Which is so
nuts. It's his address, dude.
Oh my god.
It's the primary address.
Zip code ledge.
That's where you send the Amazon packages, bro. That's 2-day shipping, please. Right to the ledge.
Oh my god. I mean, out in NYC too, that's gonna take forever. But right now, this is not looking too good for Nelvin's life expectancy. What? You know what? If it keeps working, I guess do it. But oh, the V-reverse tried to catch him with the side V on the way back in. I honestly can't count how many times that Numbers has actually been hit by Banana. Like, the amount of times he just shields and never gets punished.
Yeah.
Like, it's actually been incredibly good so far in this matchup.
This is the other thing too, though. Diddy's so good at usually resetting neutral, but Wii Fit has the neutral V to charge up, dude. Like, just so many tools that Wii Fit can kind of set up from a long range shoot. Great try with that tilt too. Lingering hitbox, not connecting.
Yeah, oh my god, and you gotta watch out for that reverse hit at F tilt too. Like, Nelvin definitely looks like he's trying to play the matchup a little differently so far. He's trying to play a bit slower, try and find maybe a down tilt as an answer, but Numbers just keep smacking him away. Like, I want nothing to do with you.
And Nelvin playing it right, like, just chilling, trying not to get hit there by the header. Still did. Hold on. Oh my god, he juked right for 1 second. Imagine.
Dude, you know what? I need to see Nelvin, like, intentionally throw the banana downward to go for a throw at this point. Like, the amount of times he keeps going for it. Oh, there we go. Finally finds the chip. Still doesn't get the KO, though, because he has no rage.
Yeah, this is exactly. Here's the thing, too, AJ. You got to consider the whole context of the set right now, right?
Yeah.
Nelvin down, not just a stock, but 2 games against John Numbers. Got to go up and play on his counter pick twice and win 2 other ones if you can make this comeback happen in game 3.
Yeah.
You're just in for a long set. Mentally, you just got to lock it in.
Yeah, 100% agreed. Like, the biggest things, like, you got to catch on to where things aren't working. That's all fake, but you got hit by it. Like, this character doesn't have a lot of combos, but sometimes, like,
I don't know why that
worked, but it did. All right, Nelvin gets himself back on the board.
For forward smash, too, just trying to get any damage. I feel like that's just reaching a little bit, though. You got to try and mix it up, too, though. Don't play that game with Numbers, man.
Yeah, I think the grab game needs to be more live. Like, that's the biggest thing that I've noticed. Numbers gets away with shielding so much. Yeah, you know, you have side B, it's predictable.
Oh, it was
that
so
backer,
good.
Though,
that was
is so
good.
Strong.
Mm-hmm. Good mix on the timing. Nelvin taking a little bit of a pause, potentially in his tournament stock here. Numbers, if he has anything to say about it, he's going to make it true. 35, though? Oh, my God. I'm surprised he didn't go for the kill, honestly. That's
yeah,
a great
I expected him to
numbers.
Double dip at that point. He's like, oh, well, I got the reversal. I got the spike.
Oh! Speaking of getting the spike, yep, there you go. He was just saving it for later. Well, the other thing is, like, even though he didn't get that spike, he didn't go for it. It's like, well, worst case scenario, now he's just getting off the ledge and in a good position to ledge trap.
Yeah.
And he's still John Numbers at the end of the day, and you're going to have to approach him and get 2 more stocks.
That was multi-game conditioning, too, because every single time that Nelvin went for higher recoveries there, Numbers only did header at the ledge. He never double jumped for it. He always stayed and forced him to recover high. But at the last set, he's like, all right, now I'm going to finally pull it out. I know you're recovering high for free all the time. You're up a stock there. You win that trade every single time.
Very nice job. No big surprises from Numbers. Mm. Great showing from Nelvin, though, getting a top 8 at this tournament. You know, Numbers, like we said, it's just always going to be a tough, tough matchup if you're not super well practiced in the matchup or anything. Nelvin showed some good proficiency in the matchup, just not quite enough to close out game stocks. Anything that he needed, but good job getting top 8 to Nelvin.
Yeah, this was a tough top 8 to crack today, too. Like,